Hi guys, my name is Christina and welcome to my channel. And on this channel, we talk all about how to create comics because this is something I'm personally interested in. I'm sharing everything I learned after creating my own comic for more than 6 years and while I'm creating it now. But we also talk a lot about art, how to create art, how to enjoy art, and how to do art professionally and earn money with your art. And I'm also sharing my own drawing processes on Monday. I'm just showing you everything I drew on the weekend, speed painting, screen recording with commentary. If any of this is interesting to you, you can engage with buttons down below and it really helps the channel, and I hope channel in turn can help you. So in this video, I wanted to talk to you about how to learn from other artists and their artwork. So learning from other artists is your biggest, best tool. Steal from them the knowledge of how to do them, and in this video, I'm gonna tell you how. It really amazes me how much opportunity we have is you have all these artists creating their art and putting their art out there. It's literally cheat sheet for you how to draw just the same. And you can just look at other artworks of other artists that you respect and artworks that you really love. I just wanted to emphasize how important it is, the fact that we have this opportunity and this ability and this stuff is available for you. Because this is how I learned to do a lot of things that I do now, just by looking at other artists and trying to replicate it. So first thing that is very important in this case, well, first of all, you need to still have some drawing practice on its own. It shouldn't be just, you know, you're going to other artists and looking at their art and trying to do this. I'm still highly recommended because I'm this old school person, very traditional and very from Russia. And I'm telling you that you should still get all your essential grammar in, which is perspective, anatomy, composition, color work, all of that stuff you need to learn to be a better artist. You need to have, because it's a grammar, right? So there's a lot of rules. And by rules, I don't mean like you have to do it, they're restricting you. No, it's just knowledge that all the artists before you accumulated and realize what works and what doesn't. And it's important for you to just take it because it's only gonna help you. And then if you wanna break these rules, you totally can, just break them right. On top of this, once you have this understanding, but you wanna improve further, it's very easy to see where you wanna go. You always, I'm assuming, because I'm as an artist, I really love other art. Not the overall art, some I don't like, but there's always a lot of artists and a lot of artwork that I really respect and I really adore and I look at it and I really love it. And when I was just starting to improve, I was looking at some artwork and be like, oh, the whole thing is perfect. How I can do the same thing, how I can do everything like this artist. Nowadays, when I realize I have my own style, I know my preference, I know what I wanna go, I know what I wanna do, I would look and kind of like take some pieces and be like, wow, this artist really knows how to work with color. The color work in this work is fantastic. Or this artist has this amazing effect that they're doing with shiny objects or with drawing metals. This is amazing. I'm gonna take that. I'm gonna learn how to do that. Now I'm just, you know, grabbing something that I think is gonna be useful for me, or sometimes I just wanted to try something. So how would you go about actually doing this? Well, first of all, identify what you like. Identify what you want to learn by looking at someone's artwork, and when you realize, oh my god, I wish I could do this, that's all you know, you grab it. And what I would do, I would look at it and try to analyze, before even drawing, before doing anything else, I would try to analyze why it works so well. Because a lot of the times, because skill that they have is some the skill that you don't have, it means you don't quite understand yet why does it work. For example, why they were able to draw metal this well, why their metal, for example, looks like metal, or why the hair the way they drew looks so well. And a lot of the time, it's really you don't know what was done, you don't know what exactly the steps that they made, and you might be like, I need a tutorial, I need something like this. You actually don't necessarily need, if this artist has a tutorial, that would be amazing, but what is important is to analyze and think why. And I think once you realize why, instead of just watching this artist doing a tutorial, or unless this artist really explaining why certain they're doing certain things and why that it makes it work, because now you process this and now you didn't even just learn the visual, how to get the look, you can implement it not in just this scenario but in every other scenario. For example, in the picture that you picked up, the metal is drawn really, really nice, and you have the sun shining on this metal really nice, like reflecting, and everything is super nice. You can copy that, it's easier, like just copy, kind of realize, okay, this thing is brighter than this thing, this is the contrast here, this is the color combination. But if you understand why you can replicate the very same thing in different lighting scenarios, in different shapes, in different forms. So analyze and think, why does it work? Maybe it is the certain color combination they're looking for the metal. For example, when drawing gold, what I realized I was way back then is that base color for gold is really very, very dirty, dark yellow, almost with green undertone, and it's really like nasty color. That's not the color that you think when you think gold. It's more like bougas type of color. So realizing that this is the base color for gold, and then you have even darker shadow, and then you have this crazy, almost lemony highlight, and that color combination makes something look made out of gold. So when I realized that, that really improved. So look, maybe it's a color combination. Look, maybe they're using different colors in the shadow. Maybe they're using different colors in the middle tone. Maybe they're using highlight differently. Maybe they're actually using highlight while you're forgetting to use highlight. Maybe they're using certain brush. Maybe they put in this certain texture. Maybe how they're working with the edge. So start paying attention why it's working, and then if it's harder for you to realize why it's working for them and not working for you, literally put together your version of what you're really liking about their image and their image next to each other, and you'll start seeing the difference, what is working and what is not. And pay attention and really study and get to the bottom of this. It's really like spending time with this and then maybe looking at other works on this artist, because chances are if they have something done in one work, they're repeating the same technique in other works. And just study and see how they're using it again and again. How does it work? Think, how is it contributing, and how, like, throughout their work, look how this method looks in different scenarios. And then once you hopefully figure it out, this is the time for practice. And once you're practicing, what I would always do, I would have my reference board somewhere. So if I'm drawing something like a portrait, I'm drawing like something like a person, and I'm interested, for example, the clothes, I want to get clothes, right? I have reference for the clothes, but also I have a reference of this artist and their style and something that I really want to implement. I have this picture open right there, and I'm looking at both and implementing both, and I always have it in front of my eyes to keep looking, and also keep looking between mine and theirs, and seeing the difference and trying to make this difference less obvious and trying to see what works and what doesn't. And just overall get really familiar with their style and with their work, so that their work starts looking right for you. Not like, oh wow, not like your work looks right for you and their work look like, wow, amazing. Make your work look like, eh, and theirs like, right. And once you get to the state, once your brain gets to the state, then you have to transition your hands to actually now get this. So now your eyes know how right things look like, and try to transition it to your work. But like, don't take it too serious in the way that I'm not saying like hate on your work, not at all. But just kind of train your eyes to see something that was super impressive for you to just normal and right, understand how it's done, figure it out how it's done to the smallest degrees. And it doesn't have, again, to be the whole thing that this artist does. Sometimes if this artist is really next level to you, which is totally normal when you're just progressing, it's okay to, you know, see this artist and say, oh my god, everything they do is better. It can be overwhelming though, so try to dissect it, or try to copy artists that are maybe not necessarily this super far yet, because don't overwhelm yourself too. It's just because it's still very important when it's kind of like you're comparing yourself to other artists, so you gotta be a little bit more gentle and PC about it to yourself, and don't stress yourself out, don't make it a self-hating exercise. It's just your learning. To me, learning is hand in hand with realizing what you're bad at. And to me, I always like to know, okay, where I'm sucking at, what is the bad thing. It doesn't mean that somebody comes to me and said, well, Christina, whatever you're doing here sucks. It doesn't mean I'm gonna take it and say, well, you're right, definitely 100%. I'm gonna filter it if I believe so. I'll address it. If I don't, I don't. But for myself, I need to understand my weak points to actually improve them. This is my kind of spiel about this. Don't make it self-hating. Don't think that your work is not good. Just have this very cool comparison. Cool, not like so cool, but more like chill, and understanding why their stuff is working and why yours is not. And it's really studying and having work of this artist in front of your eyes always, like always, just make it like imprinted in your brain, and make their way to just be so familiar to you that now when you start drawing yours, it's almost like this weird disconnect. Your hands want to do your old way, but your brain already knows that your old way is not working, and that is the way your brain is wants to push. And it might create like difficulties, because for me, I always notice that when my brain already did a jump in like improving, but my hands didn't catch up, I get like frustrated because they're not matching yet. And that's amazing stuff about other artists' work. Just go around and collect all the art that you like, all the art that really touch you in some way. Think why. It doesn't necessarily have to be something like they draw fabric really well, they draw hair really well, they draw sky really well. It's not necessarily about particular science behind them using certain brush and doing certain things. By the way, brush is not an answer. It's about technique more than about brush. I use only 4 brushes, and 2 of them I use for line work, and basically for painting I use just 2. I have a video when I show just 2 brushes that I mainly use. But it's not the secret ingredient. It's usually just technique. It's they know something that you don't yet know, and studying this stuff, you will get it. It's not sometimes though only this technical stuff. Sometimes what it is something different. Composition, the vibe, something that they bring in. For example, they're drawing portrait the moment they want to draw this person. Do they draw this person when they're just staring in the corner somewhere? Or they choose to draw the portrait with the characters animated, really excited, really emotional. Or if they're drawing landscape, did they choose to draw something calm? Or did they draw landscape engaging animals, for example? Or they draw landscape that also has some sort of a story going on, something else going on in the landscape. You see city, you see ships, somebody is doing something. Or for example, this city seems to be, you know, standing there in the distance and being peaceful, but you see like the storm is coming, and so this, the painting tells the story. Sometimes it's all these different choices that are made that not necessarily technical, not necessarily about painting. It's about storytelling aspect or emotional aspect of the piece, or like value that they wanted to put in the piece, and like something else. And this is also important to know, and this is something that it's also important to study. Every time you see somebody else's art that is really impressing you, touching you in an interesting way, maybe they just looked an interesting angle that you've never before seen, maybe the composition is really unusual, maybe it's so stylized you never see this style before, so it's so creative, maybe they use this color so fiercely on something, they decided to have the whole background crazy red and you never thought it could be done. Something like this. Don't be afraid to dissect not necessarily just the way how it's done, but what the artist that you really respect was thinking about, what they were trying to do with the art. Try to get inside their head, their mindset, and what they try to do with their painting. Try to analyze, try to think about it, and then try to implement it in your own art. And I guarantee it's gonna improve, and it's gonna be very interesting and gonna enrich your work and make you freer artist in the way that everything that we'll create, you will have this freedom and bravery to do a lot of things, because you already saw a lot of things, how things could be done, and you realize which ones are working, you realize which ones are working but you not be using because it's not your style, you will be using different things instead, and one can be done on top of it, like crazy things. And then, you know, this crazy things can be done, this creative things can be implemented. It means I can also come up with all of that stuff, so it opens all their imagination for your head and all the ways that you can create art. So don't be afraid to learn from other artists. It's not like not being afraid, this is the greatest opportunity that you have, is that there is so much art and people put their art out there and it's available. You can just check their work. You can go to, you know, art gallery, look at the art and learn from whoever, from Da Vinci, I don't know. You can learn. You have this great opportunity. So don't miss out on this opportunity. Take the most advantage. And I also put everything I draw during the weekend here on Monday, so you can learn from me. You can see everything I'm doing and I'm explaining why I'm doing it, or sometimes I talk about just my comic, my storytelling, and some art things. So I hope this video was helpful for you, and I hope you can get away something and improve your art because of this. I hope you're having a good day, and I hope you will continue to have good days till my next video. Thank you so much guys for watching, and I hope to see you in my next one.